looking ahead, in Microsoft 365, we're giving you powerful tools to allow you to forge new employee engagement experiences from the content you already have. We'll look at Spaces, which allow anyone to create immersive mixed reality environments from the information you already have. Home Sites, which deliver a powerful portal and web experience, again, based on information that users are already generating. And finally, we'll take a look at Custom Vision, a tool that allows anyone to use artificial intelligence to build powerful recognition models from images that already live inside Office 365. Let's look.
For the past 3 years, Microsoft 365 has embarked on a mission of allowing authors and creators to craft beautiful pages and portal experiences distributed throughout SharePoint, Microsoft Teams, OneDrive, and beyond, integrating new content and new experiences. We're calling this Home Sites. Let's take a look. As I scroll down the page, I can see spotlighted news content, which are beautiful views of pages that team authors or organization authors create to distribute around the organization. We can also integrate stream video using our stream web part on this page. Conversations from outside and inside Contoso are integrated using the Twitter and Yammer web parts, respectively. We can see spotlighted links for communities that require more attention, a product countdown, as well as the usual bits that we would expect to keep an employee engaged about local weather and time at some of our offices around the world, along with content drawn from Microsoft 365's services platform with personalized views based on who I am and what I've last accessed, looking at documents as well as sites and recommendations for things I might want to pay more attention to. Finally, things going on in my team are surfaced on this homepage experience for me as well. Elements of Home Sites have been introduced over the past 3 years, but we innovated Home Sites as detailed in our announcement at SharePoint Conference in May 2019, with availability starting immediately thereafter. Let's take a look at another element that I can introduce on Home Sites based upon SharePoint Spaces. SharePoint Spaces, currently in private preview with hundreds of customers, allows organizations to create immersive virtual reality experiences from the 2D and 3D content they already have in their Office 365 repositories. They can embed these into beautiful immersive spaces that can be experienced on a headset or directly inside of the browser. Let's take a look at an example of these. We can see videos that someone can experience directly in the browser, animated in a 3D space and fully scrollable for interactive views. We can also take a look at some of those 3D immersive photography elements we talked about before. Here we see an element of the Microsoft campus as it looked prior to our current campus refresh, buildings 1, 2, 3, and 4, surrounding an artificial body of water that we all love to call Lake Bill. These kinds of deep immersive experiences are available for anyone to create, and through our browser plugins, available for even more people to experience with or without headset technologies. Let's take a look at the last of our innovations, which is how we innovate around classification of images and rich digital objects. The image classification we looked at earlier in storefronts is based upon Microsoft's Custom Vision technology, part of our Azure Cognitive Services offering. Let's take a look at one of our classification models. Building a classification model is as simple as uploading and tagging images and clicking the train button here in the upper right-hand corner. Let's show you how that works. Here, I'm going to browse for a new storefront image that I want to upload. I can decide how I want to tag this image. This particular model is based on recognizing technical equipment for the travel industry. We don't see anything that looks like an overhead bin or an airline seat, so we can say this is a negative image. Images that look like this should not be classified with one of the other tags that's out there. Let's upload this file, and we're done. To finish the model, all I need to do is click the train button to say that it's ready to generate a new cognitive services model, And based on the number of images we have, in a few seconds, we will have an even more intelligent classification scheme to be able to plug into Microsoft Flow. We think it's important to be able to allow these tools to be brought into the mainstream for anyone to be able to use them with standard productivity skills.
And now we want to showcase our latest innovation, as announced at SharePoint Conference in May 2019 and rolling out pleasantly to Office 365 customers worldwide. Using our classification engine, we can also create labels which manage the sensitivity of information. Here, I'm looking at some of the critical sensitivity labels that I've established for my organization. My label for the executive team is used to govern our most sensitive content. Let's take a look at what it means behind the scenes. We can see what labels are going to be used to define this in tooltips. And most importantly, we can see that if this label is applied to content, it will be encrypted not just at rest in the service, but upon download from the application. We can also choose to extend these policies for data loss prevention, watermarking, and group security. Let's take a look at how this label impacts collaboration inside Office 365. Here, I'm looking at my sales and marketing team site. We can see that some of these files have already been tagged with the sensitivity label. Let's open up one of these files and see how it works. My experience working with the file for authors, for co-authoring, search, and all other aspects of collaboration is exactly the same as it is for non-sensitive and non-encrypted documents. I can come make any change that I need to, and all of the same policies and rules remain in effect. My sensitivity labels are also extended throughout the Office client applications. So here in the web, as well as in the rich client, I can see that this is tagged for executive team only, which will enforce the encryption standards that I've defined inside of the compliance center. The same capabilities are automatically extended to content when we see changes dynamically. I'm looking at my customer accounts file, which lists social security numbers and credit card numbers, and I can see that it's already detected this contains sensitive information. And if I open up the file, I can see with my own eyes what Microsoft's 365 sensitivity labels automatically determined. We have customer IDs and credit card numbers, making sure I want to automatically apply sensitivity standards to how I work with this document. We're continuing to innovate on what we can deliver to ensure that your information remains dynamically and automatically protected for retention and sensitivity as a core part of our content services offering.